大家好，我叫 Alex 司马炎，我是 Wagon Shenzhen 校区的项目负责人。那今天我跟大家讨论一个话题，就是我应该从哪一个编程语言开始学习。So, which programming language should I learn first? Now, it's not that easy of a question to answer, and it really does depend on each person who's asking the question. But we can look at this question in three different ways. Number one, is the programming language that you're trying to learn approachable? Number two, is the programming language you're trying to learn built around a large community? And number three, is that programming language fitting with your needs? So number one, is your coding language approachable?Now, what this means is that, is the language that you're using to code, is the syntax simple or is it complex? What I mean by that is, does it closely resemble the English language, the spoken language, or is it too complex where it seems like you're learning Latin or maybe even Chinese? So what you want to do is first find a language that is simple and easy to write, something like Ruby, which is designed for developer happiness.Or Python, which is also designed to make coding very, very simple. Number two, does this language have a large community? Now, what this means is that when you're learning your language for the first time, it's gonna be difficult. You're gonna run into roadblockers, you're gonna run into problems that you don't know how to solve, and you're gonna need a lot of support. Now, that support is going to come from people who have learned this language before. So a programming language that has a large community means that you have more support, more people that have gone through the same path that you're currently going through, and more answers to questions that you have. So when you're finding which language to learn first, make sure that that language has a large community. And finally, number three, does this programming language fit with your personal goals? Now you have to look at why you want to be a programmer in the first place.If you want to build iOS applications, then you might want to learn Swift. Swift was made by Apple in order to build macOS applications. Now, if you wanted to build Android applications instead, then it might be important for you to use Java, which is a cross-platform programming language. Moving down the line, if you wanted to build websites, say for small businesses or medium-sized businesses, then it might be important to learn PHP, because a lot of these small, medium-sized businesses will already have websites built on WordPress.And WordPress is built on PHP. Now, if you want to be a data scientist, then it might be interesting for you to learn Python. Python is becoming more and more popular nowadays for data science, for developing algorithms which help to read different sets of data and produce analysis. And finally, if you want to be more of an entrepreneur, if you want to be a creative type, if you want to be someone who is an innovator, then it might be important for you to learn Ruby. Now, Ruby has become very popular with Ruby on Rails, which is a web development framework which allows developers to very, very quickly develop full-scale applications, prototype full-scale applications from idea into reality. So it doesn't really matter which programming language you learn first.What really matters is how much time and effort you put into learning that first programming language. Now this means building projects, constantly building projects. This means learning new techniques. This means reading material that's put out into the community about what's coming out new in the language. This means that you're at least spending 1,000 hours in front of your computer using this language. Now what that'll do is that'll get you really, really good at the fundamentals.And when you're starting to learn your second, your third, and your fourth languages, you'll find that it's much, much easier to become fluent in those languages when you've already mastered your first. So from all of us here at Wagon, we wish you good luck in your journey and keep coding.